Welcome to Gnome on the Room story time. Public Library. Today we're at Heritage Hill Farm with Mr. Thompson, owner, operator of the farm. We're going to talk a little bit to Mr. Thompson about what they do here.
We actually raise grain. We raise corn, soybeans, wheat, and hay. The soybeans and the corn actually are sold and they're stored in these bins until we deliver it to the market, if you will. Some of the soybeans end up going to the chicken farm where they lay eggs and they feed those chickens with those soybeans. And as I mentioned earlier, we crush those soybeans. We don't, but they do, and extract the oil out of them. So, and the corn actually goes to an ethanol plant where they make fuel that runs in cars and trucks, and a good deal of it goes to feed cattle or pigs.
So how many acres do you harvest each year?
Around 5,000.
Wow, that's a lot of acres.
It is.
So that's why they have this big equipment around here that takes a lot of time to plant and harvest all of these crops. So how long has the farm been in existence?
Well, we arrived in 1985, so shortly after that, 1987 is when we started farming. Today, I'm blessed because my son and my daughter-in-law actually operate the farm, Chad and Lacey Thompson. And now our two grandsons are involved, which is my daughter's two sons, Hayden and Hunter. So.
Excellent. So we're glad to have Mr. Thompson and his family here in Kinsman. If you come by Good Intentions, you'll see their big green bins behind the building. And we'll hope to see you next time. Thanks for having us out.
Anytime. Please come back.
Thank you. This story is called Machines on the Farm by Cyan Smith. Why do we have machines on the farm? Do you know? A farm is a place where animals are kept or plants are grown, and farmers sell the plants and animals for people to eat. There are many jobs that need to be done on the farms, and the different machines make the jobs easier to do. Which farm machines are the most useful? It depends what you're doing. Tractors are very useful farm machines. Their large back wheels help them move in the mud without getting stuck. Farmers use tractors to pull many different farm machines. A plow is used to dig up the ground before planting seeds. Here's the plow. Which farm machines plant seeds? Planting machines pulled by tractors plant seeds or plants in the ground. Seed drills plant seeds in rows in the soil. Planters plant young plants in the ground, and planting machines allow farmers to plant many seeds or plants at a time. How do machines help us to grow plants? Farm machines can be used to water plants, and sometimes the water can be controlled by clocks called timers. Some machines spray pesticides to kill the insects that eat the plants. And on some big farms, helicopters are used to spray pesticides or airplanes. Which machines help to harvest the plants? The combine harvesters help farmers harvest or pick grain plants, like soybeans and corn. They can cut the plants and collect the seeds, and then they take the seeds out of their cases and leave the straw behind. Other machines take the straw or hay from the cut grass and make it into bales. They roll or crush it into round or square bales and tie it up. Maybe you've seen these in the fields. Sometimes they're wrapped in white plastic. I like to call those marshmallow farms. Do all harvesting machines look the same? No. Harvesting machines that pick and sort different types of plants can look very different. Some large machines can be used to pick and sort tomatoes. Grape picking machines have a large gap in the middle so that they can drive along rows of grapevines. The machine shakes the grapevines and collects the grapes that fall down. Some machines harvest vegetables that grow under the ground. They pull the vegetables out or dig them up, and the vegetables move along a belt and the machine gets rid of the soil. Some machines collect fruit that grows on trees. Olive harvesters shake the trees and catch the fruit that falls off. Which farm machines milk cows? The farmers use a milker to milk cows, and the farmer puts a milker onto each cow's four teats. When the machine starts, the milkers suck out milk, and the pipes take the milk into large tanks to keep it cool. When there's no more milk, the milkers drop off. What other machines are used on the farm? Farmers use other machines to help with many different jobs. Tree cutters and other machines are used to keep farms safe and neat. Machines are used to sort and pack food items, like eggs. An egg sorter puts small, medium, and large eggs into cartons, and the farmer can sell the different eggs at different prices. What does this machine do? Can you guess? It's spraying something smelly. I think it's cow manure. And those are a few machines you may see on the farm. Today I'm reading Duck on a Tractor by David Shannon. Down on the farm, Duck sometimes got wild ideas, and one day he decided he could ride a bike, and so he did. Maybe you've heard that story. Then he spotted the tractor. "I bet I can drive a tractor," he said. The other animals weren't so sure, but they all said, "Well, if he can ride a bike, maybe he can drive a tractor too." What do you think? Have you ever seen a duck drive a tractor? Duck climbed on the tractor and looked around. He pushed some pedals and wiggled a metal stick, but nothing happened. Then a shiny little piece of metal by the steering wheel caught his eye, and he pulled it out. He pushed it in, and then he turned it. All of a sudden, the tractor shook and coughed and rumbled, and it began to move. At first, it moved very slowly, and it jerked a lot, but it was fun. Duck drove down around the barnyard until he got the hang of it, and then he stopped in front of the other animals. "Climb on, everybody," he said. Oh, dear. The dog was first. He jumped right up next to the duck and said, what does a dog say? The dog said, "Woof." But what he thought was, "We're going for a ride." To everyone's surprise, the cow clambered on next. What does a cow say? "Moo," of course. But what she thought was, "This is the silliest thing I have ever done." Pig and Pig took a seat in the back. "Oink, oink," said Pig and Pig. But what they thought was, "This sure beats walking." And there they went. Then came Chicken, Mouse, and Goat. What does the chicken say? "Bark, bark, bark." But what she thought was, "The last one on is a rotten egg." "Squeak," said Mouse. But what she thought was, "I can see everything from up here." "Ma," said Goat. But what he thought was, "I'm hungry. Does the garbage dump have a drive-through window?" Next up were the horse and cat. The cat jumped up gracefully onto the tractor. The horse, not so much. "Meow," said the cat. But what she thought was, "I was going to take a nap, but this should be very interesting." The horse came along, and what does a horse say? A horse says, "Neigh." But what he thought was, "I'd rather walk." The only one left on the ground was the sheep. And what does a sheep say? That's right, a sheep says, "Baa." But what she thought was, "This is too dangerous." "Get on, sheep," everyone shouted. But sheep wouldn't budge, so Duck started driving away without her. "Wait," cried sheep, "don't leave me here all alone." She ran after the tractor and took a flying leap onto it. And the duck yelled, quack. But what he thought was, whoa. Oh dear, this looks like nothing but trouble. The duck steered the tractor down the lane and out onto the main road, and before long they were driving right through the middle of town. It was lunchtime, so most people were in the diner. They all looked up when Duck and the other animals passed by the big window. A little boy named Edison was having lunch with his grandma. Did you ever? Grandma gasped. But what she thought was, a duck on a tractor? That's impossible. That's totally awesome, Edison shouted. But what he thought was, no one's gonna believe this. The waitress looked up from her pad and noticed the cat. Heavens to Betsy, she explained. What she thought was, I like cats. Deputy Bob blabbered, if that don't beat all. But what he thought was, how am I gonna explain this to the sheriff? I don't know. A man named Otis chimed in, I must be seeing things. But what he thought was, oh no, not again. Holy cow, said the cook. And what he thought was, holy cow, because Manny usually said exactly what he was thinking. The mayor almost choked on his pie. Good gravy, he sputtered. But what he thought was, those pigs are even fatter than I am. Ooh, Corky just whistled, but what he thought was, that duck is smarter than he looks. Gwen came out of the restroom. Would you look at that? But what she thought was, I can't see anything without my glasses. Farmer Odell observed. That's a nice tractor. But what he really thought was, hey, that's my tractor. Uh-oh. He decided he'd better go after it and ran out the door, and everyone else ran out too and chased right after them. By this time, the duck had turned onto the next street. The tractor shuddered to a stop. The duck tried turning the shiny little piece of metal again, but nothing happened. I don't know how much about spelling, said Dog, but I think E means it's the end of our ride. She cleared her throat. You know, I think we might be in trouble for this. Do you think? Let's get out of here, yelled Duck. Just as Farmer Odell and everyone from the diner came around the corner. Everyone burst out laughing. Yeah, it couldn't have been. It was an optical illusion, said the farmer. Maybe I left my tractor running by accident. I guess that explains it, said Deputy Bob. And they all went back to the diner to finish their lunch. And no one ever admitted that on that day, they had seen a cow, a goat, a cat, a dog, a sheep, a chicken, a horse, two pigs, a mouse, and a duck on what? On a tractor. What is he going to get into next? So I'm here with Mr. Thompson, where it's harvest time at Heritage Hill Farm. We're in the field, and he's going to tell us a little bit about what they're harvesting today.
Today we're harvesting soybeans, and these are examples of what the finished soybean looks like when it's ripe. We started harvesting about 4 weeks ago, and we're going to finish today, and then we'll start our corn harvest. But the soybean itself, after it's extracted from this pod, you have the bean, and we'll actually crush the bean or squeeze it, and from that crush we'll get oil and we'll get soybean meal, much like a flour. And so the soybean meal is used for feed, cattle, pigs, chickens, and the oil is actually used in a number of things. Paint, glue, and just a variety of things, but that's how they're processed, so.
This is where your soybeans come from, out of the field on the farm. Thanks for having us out today.
No problem, it's a great day.
Thanks for joining us for Gnome on the Roam Storytime. We'll see you next time.